In yesterday's session, we have discussed about basics of testing, what is meant by automation, what are the different tools available in the market, what is the difference between say QTP and Selenium and QTP, right? Today we are going to see about in detail about Selenium. Okay, what are the components are there in Selenium? What are the drawbacks of the older components? What are the updates of the new components? All those things we are going to see today. Now, just we had an introduction yesterday about Selenium also. Selenium was invented in the year 2004 by Jason Huggins, and the company which supported to do that is ThoughtWorks. That is what we have saw yesterday. We can see in detail about Selenium. Selenium comprises of three components, that is Selenium IDE, RC, and WebDriver. These are the three components of Selenium. Selenium IDE is nothing but integrated development environment. RC is nothing but remote control, and WebDriver is nothing but the latest version what we have. In the year 2004 they have implemented Selenium IDE. Later on in the year 2007 they have found the drawbacks of Selenium IDE and overtaken by Selenium RC. In the year 2008 they have implemented Selenium WebDriver. Today we are going to learn about Selenium IDE. Now we are going to learn about Selenium IDE and see the basics of what are the drawbacks of the Selenium IDE, why they have moved to Selenium RC, we can see now. Before that, if you work on Selenium IDE, directly we can come to know about the features of Selenium IDE. That's why I'm going to directly work on Selenium IDE now and see the drawbacks of the Selenium IDE later. Okay. Selenium IDE. Don't take down, I'll give you time to take down, listen. Selenium IDE. First, let us see the installation of Selenium IDE. Later on, I will tell you that advantages of the Selenium IDE and drawbacks of the Selenium IDE. Okay. First, let us see the installation of Selenium IDE. Normally, how will you install any tool? For example, if you want to install a VLC media player, how will you install? Just a minute. Installation of Selenium IDE. We can see normally how will you install any tool? If you get VLC, you will download a .exe file, then click on next and install. Why you click on next? Online girls and guys, you also can answer. Okay, that is I accept only one. What about others? Other next. Even I don't know why we click on next. Just click on. Yeah, that is setting path, extracting the jar files. Each and every step, there will be a meaning, but we no need to worry about that. That is done by developers and they will be giving us a package to us. We will install it and we will use that software normally. But installation of Selenium IDE is quite different. How in the sense, it is not an .exe file. It is an add-on to the Mozilla Firefox browser. It is an add-on to the Mozilla Firefox browser. Since it is an add-on to the Mozilla Firefox browser, first you want to install the Mozilla Firefox browser. Upon Mozilla Firefox browser, you want to install this add-on. Directly you cannot install this without having Mozilla Firefox browser, because the Selenium IDE, it is an add-on to the Mozilla Firefox browser. See, yesterday when we saw about the difference between Selenium and QTP, I said Selenium supports all the browsers, right? But the Selenium IDE doesn't support all the browsers. That is the drawback. One more drawback why they have moved to RC and WebDriver later. It supports only Mozilla Firefox browser. Don't take down. I will add few more points to this later on. I will tell you to take down. It supports only Mozilla Firefox browser. It is an add-on to the Mozilla Firefox browser. Now, how to install this Selenium IDE? We can see in detail about how to install this Selenium IDE. First, open Mozilla Firefox browser. Open Mozilla Firefox. Don't open Chrome and do all those things and come and complain me, because I see that every batch. Even if I tell you to open Chrome and do all these steps and tell me, sir, it is not getting installed. It is an add-on to the Mozilla Firefox browser. Go to Mozilla Firefox browser. Go to URL called seleniumhq.org. Go to seleniumhq.org. Under seleniumhq.org, you will get a tab called download tab. Click on this download tab. You will get many subheadings like Selenium standalone server, Internet Explorer driver, Selenium client. Like this, search for Selenium IDE subsection. Are you getting any Selenium IDE subsection? Yes, Selenium IDE subsection is there, right? Here, for Firefox is there, right? Click on this for Firefox. Check whether your Add to Firefox button is enabled here. It is not enabled. It is telling the this add-on requires new version of Firefox, at least 56.0. You are using 46.0. I am using 46.0. That's why what I am going. I am going back. Go to the Selenium IDE. Previous IDE versions are there, right? Click on this previous IDE version. Okay, be careful with old versions. Come down, somewhere any one of the Add to Firefox button will be enabled. This Add to Firefox button is enabled now. Click on this Add to Firefox button. Click on Install and click on Restart. It will restart only Mozilla Firefox browser. Okay, open Mozilla Firefox browser. Go to seleniumhq.org. Go to Downloads. Under Selenium IDE subsection, click on Previous IDE versions. Then click on Add to Firefox button. Okay, can you repeat the steps once again? Open Mozilla Firefox browser. Go to seleniumhq.org. Click on Download. Under Selenium IDE subsection, click on Previous IDE version. Click on Add to Firefox button. Then click on Install. That's it. Selenium IDE will get. Once Selenium IDE gets installed, listen, I said I will give you clear step-by-step notes. You will get the Selenium IDE IDE icon here. Once you install Selenium IDE. Or else if you don't get that also, no need to worry. Go to Tools, you will find Selenium IDE here. Which means that you have successfully installed your Selenium IDE. Click on the Selenium IDE, Selenium IDE tool. This is the Selenium IDE tool. You have installed that Selenium IDE. Now we are going to start working with the Selenium IDE. Okay. Open Mozilla Firefox browser. Go to seleniumhq.org. Click on Download tab. Under Selenium IDE subsection, click on previous Selenium IDE versions link, then click on install and restart. That's it. This is all about installation of Selenium. Take down this now. Sorry. Good. Con add to Firefox button. Okay, take down this. The Selenium IDE, it is just a record and playback tool. It is just a record and playback tool. I will let you know what is this record and playback tool. It is just a record and playback tool. Yeah. Okay. 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 Okay, any one button will be enabled for you, right? That's it. Only one will be supported for you, not all other. Click on that which is enabled. It will get installed. Yeah, click on that. It will be installed. You can go with anyone, not a problem. I will let you know now. That is the next step I am going to tell you. Which version of Firefox if you use, that would be better. All those things I will let you know now. See, open Mozilla Firefox browser, go to help, about Firefox. If you don't get this help right, don't tell that I didn't get that help. That is a menu bar. If you don't get that menu bar, right click here and get that menu bar. Go to help, about Firefox is there, right? Here I am using 46.0. And I have stopped the updates. Okay, 46, a little bit old version. Okay, the recent version is 62.0 or something is going on now with Firefox. You go with 46.0 itself. I will let you know how to work with the latest versions, all those things. After some 10 to 15 classes, I will let you know how to work with the updated versions, all those things. Until that, let us use outdated versions, see the drawbacks of these, and go with the updated versions. Okay. First, go home. If you have the old new version of Firefox browser, uninstall that. Or else, if you have two old version of Firefox browser, uninstall that, and go with 46.0. Go with 46.0. Once you go with 46.0, approximately, accurately, this Add to Firefox button will be enabled. Others will be grayed out. Other Add to Firefox buttons will be grayed out. Just click on this and install it. Okay, because once we start with Selenium web driver again, initially we will start with 46.0. Right now, go with 46.0. Where to download this 46.0? If you have that confusion, take down this as a running notes. Where to get the 46.0 of Firefox browser? Normally, I will use filehippo.com. I will use filehippo.com. That is a website where I used to download all kinds of softwares. I'll go to the browsers here. I'll go to this browsers. Under this browsers, I'll go to this Firefox. I'll find all the Firefox versions here. 62.0 beta version is there. 62.0. Here you have old versions, view more, right? Click on this view more. You will find all the versions of Firefox browser. Now in this page it is showing 62.0. Second page, if you go, it will show 61.0. It is showing 61.0. This is the standard versions. Okay, like that, if you go to the seventh page, you will find some 59.0. Now I am in the seventh page, right? Let me go to some 23rd page or somewhere. You will find 46.0. What happened? I'm going to 23rd page. Okay, 47.0 is there. 46.0.1. Let me go to 24th page. 46.0 is there, right? Don't go with 46.0.1 and all those versions, beta versions and all. Go with the standard version itself. 46.0. Click on this. Once you click on this, you will get download this version. Click on this, download this version. You will get a .exe file of Firefox browser. Firefox.exe. Download that and install it. If you have the old version, uninstall it. And very new version, uninstall that and use this version. And once you install this, stop the updates of Firefox. Or else what happens, once you restart your machine, it will get updated to 62 version automatically. You have to stop the updates of Firefox browser. Take down where to stop the updates. Open Mozilla Firefox browser. Take down this as running notes. These are some basics what you have to learn, should know by yourself, but still I will be giving. Use 46 version of Firefox browser and stop the updates of Firefox browser. Go to tools, under options, go to tools, arrow mark options. Go to tools, arrow mark options. Go to tools, arrow mark options. Arrow mark advanced, arrow mark advanced, arrow mark update, arrow mark update, and here never check for updates radio button is there, right? Click on never check for radio, never check for updates radio button. It will not update at all. So that it will remain constantly in 46.0. Then start installing your Selenium IDE. Before installing Selenium IDE, make sure you use your 46 version. Priya, now are you, someone have asked the doubts related to this, right? Now it's clear. Okay, fine. Now use 46.0 version and install the Selenium IDE and start working with the Selenium IDE. Okay, clear? With installation, any doubts with installation, I'm going to start working with Selenium IDE. Before working with Selenium IDE, I need some application to work, right? Wherever you learn through Google, they will be always guiding you to work on Gmail or Facebook. Let us work with some real-time scenarios. Okay, I'm going to open an application called demo.actitime.com. That is not www.actitime.com, or else don't use www.demo.actitime.com. Don't use those things in URL. Just type demo.actitime.com. Don't type any other thing in the URL. demo.actitime.com and hit enter. It will open. That application will open. Don't come and complain me, sir, that is not opening. I have opened. I have given http://actitime.com. It is showing some other website. Just type demo.actitime.com. Don't type any other thing in the URL. And hit enter. It will open this application. The username for this application is admin. And the password for this application is manager. And if I change the username and password, I will change it here also. No need to worry about that. In future, every December 31st night, I will change the username and password. Yearly once, I will change the username and password for this application. Admin and manager. This is really a good application for beginners to learn. Because intentionally, I have made some bugs here. Where you can, it will not be that easy to identify the bugs. Okay, what is this application is meant for in the sense? This is a time tracking application, which is used by many companies. If you want to know which are the companies which are using, I will let you know about that also. This, see, for example, you are working in a company called Accenture. In Accenture, there will be at least in one particular location itself, there will be at least 10 to 15 projects in a particular location. Everyone will be entering in a common gate and exiting in a common gate. Each and everyone will have different login times and logout times. And each and every project will have different time constraints. Some projects will have 8 hours of work culture and some projects will have 9 hours of work culture. They need to track the time. HRs has to track the time of your effective time of usage what you have worked in your office. Right? Once you log in and log out, they need to track the time. For that, they will be using this application, time track application. Okay. Big clients are using this application. Like, you can go to www.actitime.com and click on partners. See, this is Xerox, Cisco, Philips, CMC, Accenture, General Electric, Siemens. These are the biggest clients what that Actitime has been used. Okay. And going further also, I'll be using this Actitime a little bit in some cases. In few cases, I'll use Flipkart, Amazon, all these things also. I'll try to use this Actitime application. If you want this into your local machine also, if you can bring your local machine, or else I will give you .exe file if you want. You can install that into your machine. And once you will get an icon in desktop. Just double click on that icon, it will open in the browser. You no need internet also. If you want that, I will give you the software also going further. Okay, so that without internet also you can start working. So local, I can make it as a local and I can give it. I have exe file with me. This is all about, as of now, I log in and log out. I know login and logout scenario in this, right? I can do a log, I can check the login functionality. I can automate the login functionality here by using Selenium IDE. Okay, I have opened the Mozilla Firefox browser, installed Selenium IDE, and I have an application to automate. Now I am going to automate that scenario. Automate the login scenario of this demo.actitime.com and check whether login is working fine or not. Now, close everything, start from the beginning. Go to Tools, Selenium IDE. This is the Selenium IDE tool, right? Keep the Selenium IDE tool aside and this is the Firefox browser. Let me keep both parallelly and start working with this Selenium IDE. Go to seleniumhq.org. Sorry. Just a minute. Open Mozilla Firefox browser. Go to Selenium ID. This is the Selenium ID tool. See, this is the record button, right? Look here. This is the record button. No notes for the Selenium ID. Only for the Selenium ID. Going from tomorrow's class onwards, everything you will have very clear notes. You will be starting the course syllabus from might be tomorrow's class onwards. Only for the Selenium IDE, in real time they won't use the Selenium IDE at all. Just to find out the drawbacks, we are working on this, and you will not get any interview questions also on this for sure. Once you open the Selenium IDE, check. This is the record button. What it is showing? Now recording. Click to stop recording. Okay. Whatever you do here in the browser, that will get recorded here. I am going to open demo.actitime.com. Demo.actitime.com. I am going to enter the username as admin. See, that is getting recorded here. That is getting recorded here. Now if I enter manager, that is getting recorded there. And if I click on login, that is each and every action what I do here, that is getting recorded here, right? Now if I stop recording and if I do something here, will it get recorded? No, because I have stopped recording there. I have logged out, but that logout action has not recorded here. Are you getting this? Now I have recorded a login step. Up to login I have recorded, right? Now if I run using this button, it will open demo.actitime.com. Enter admin manager, click on login. It has done. I didn't run that. Automation script has ran it and it has automated. Okay. It is running very quickly. You are unable to see the speed of execution, right? Yes or no? Shall we do this task once again from the beginning? Let me close this Selenium IDE. Start from the beginning. What is the next step? Go to tools, Selenium IDE. Check whether recording button is in on or not. Yes, it is in on. Do some actions like open demo.actitime.com or else open icicibank.com. Enter your admin manager password and click on login. It has logged in. Now stop recording. Stop recording. I have stopped recording. Now let me log out and check. It should not work. That is exactly correct what I'm guessing. Now slow down the speed of execution, so that it will run slowly. Now run it by using this button. It will open demo.actitime.com. Enter admin, enter manager, click on login. It is running step by step, right? Now I have automated a login scenario. Now are you understanding what is meant by automation? Now if I save this test case and if I come tomorrow and if I run, I can run it. I will let you know how to save the test case, how to run all those things also. This is just to show you a demo of how automation works. Instead of this, we can write a piece of Java code, and if I run that Java code, it has to do those same actions. How to write the Java code, we will learn in Selenium WebDriver. Okay. Now close this. Don't save. Let me do that from the beginning. What I will do is, I will open this tool, Selenium IDE. I am going to repeat this once again. Check whether this record is in on or not. Minimize this. Tell your friend to open icicibank.com. Okay. Tell your friend to open I didn't kill the session. Kill the session. Do it. Go to tools, Selenium IDE, record is in on, minimize this, tell your friend to open icicibank.com. Okay, tell him to enter username, that is username and password, and click on login. Okay, then tell him to go out of from your laptop, open this and check you have got his username and password, login into his account and transfer all the funds. Is it a secured one?
No.
Is Selenium IDE? You can get the password. It's very less secured. Okay. Security levels are very less. This is one of the drawback. And I can use only in Mozilla Firefox browser. And there is no way that I can, if I want to log in and log out 10 times, I want to manually execute once and record it once. Execute once. I mean, I want to execute that once, record and keep it there and do that again. I cannot loop it anywhere. Programming is not possible here. If programming is there, what I can do, I can loop this in a for loop and put this code inside a for loop and run it for 10 times so that it will log in and log out for 10 times. Descriptive programming is not possible. Lot of drawbacks what we are finding on the Selenium IDE, right? That is why they have moved to Selenium RC later in 2007. Once they have moved to Selenium RC, it is the code which is similar to WebDriver only. But if they use Selenium RC, when they are running, it will run very slowly. That's why they have moved to Selenium WebDriver later. We are going to see completely on Selenium WebDriver. But before that, we can see some basics of the Selenium IDE. Okay. Now, let us record a test case, save the test case, and do all those things now. Go to Selenium IDE, start recording, open demo.actitime.com. Oh, sorry. Kill the session or else it makes a problem again. Open demo.actitime.com. Enter admin, done, manager, done. Click on login. I have completed. Now I am going to save this test case. How to save the test case? Go to file, save test case. Today I have recorded one test case. Save test case. All your files will be under F, under class. I am going to create a new folder for you. That is batch 105. At the end of the classes, you will be having a lot of Java programs and WebDriver programs. So all your programs will be under this particular folder. I will zip this folder and I will send you at the last day. So that you will get all the programs also. I am going to save this as login. This test case I have saved as login. I can go home today, come back tomorrow again. I have saved one test case yesterday, right? Just now I have saved one test case, right? Come back tomorrow again. Go to tools, Selenium IDE, go to file, open. Yesterday you have recorded one test case, right? Login test case, open the test case, it is there. Now slow down the speed of execution, run it. Open demo.actitime.com, enter admin manager, click on login, it has done. Now one test case has, I have saved at least some 30 seconds of time, right? Login test case takes at least some 30 seconds of time, half a minute I have saved. Saved my manual effort. In the same way, you can record many test cases, keep it ready and run it. But there are some drawbacks. This is how automation helps in reducing the manual effort. Okay, let us record few more test cases. This application is having some error. Again, if I do the same thing, it will execute. Now it is executing. With the same IP, if you are trying to log in for several times, right? Without that IP should be registered in our portal. If it is not registered, then we will be showing such kind of errors. That is the reason. There is no bug. Now if I run this once again, right, it will run properly. That is application issue, not the script issue. Now run this. It will open demo.actitime.com. Enter admin, manager, click on login. It will log in. I didn't do anything now. Still, it will work fine. Done. Now, let us do few more things to this. I am going to log in and log out. That is a complete cycle, right? Login scenario, if I want to check. I want to log in and log out also. Do a complete stretch. Complete scenario. What are the steps to do? Open demo.actitime.com. Enter admin, manager, click on login. After logging in, I need to log out. Check whether logout is also recorded. Click on logout. That is getting recorded. Yes. Now stop recording and start running your test case. Now slow down the speed of execution and run it. It has to run fine, right? Yes or no? Yes. Now run it. Open demo.actitime.com, enter admin, manager, click on login. and it has thrown an error here, red color. Why? What is the reason? Yes. The reason is, after logging in, it is taking some time to load the page. But when your Selenium ID keeps on executing, it will execute continuously one after the other. How to solve this issue? How to solve this issue? After logging in, make the system to sleep for some time. Again, try to wake that up. Make it to sleep for some 5 or 10 seconds or 20 seconds or 30 seconds. So that it will sleep there for the amount of time what you have given. After that, it will wake up and it will do its task. See, if you want to execute these lines line by line, this is the first open, right? It opens demo.actitime. Double click on this. It will open demo.actitime.com. Double click on this. It will enter admin in the username text box. If you double click on this, what happens? Enters password in the password box. Enter manager in the password. Double click is nothing but execute that particular statement. Now click on login. It has logged in. If you execute line by line, you will come to know about that. But if you when you run the automation test case, you will not run line by line. You will execute all of it. And if you click on logout, you can log out of the application. But in between login and logout, I need to wait for some time. That is my only goal here. In between login and logout, I need to wait for some time. What I can do is, after logging in, I need to wait for some time, right? Here, single click on login, instead of click, use click and wait. Click and wait. So that what happens here in the sense, it will click on login and it will wait for the amount of time the page loads. It will wait for maximum of 30 seconds. Even though if it doesn't load in 30 seconds, right, it will throw you an error. Okay, how to change the time, why they have set all those time, I will let you know. But by default, it will wait for 30 seconds. Now if I run this, it has to work fine, right? Because I have used click and wait. Now run this and check. Run this. It will open demo.actitime.com. It will enter admin, manager, click on login. See, it is waiting there. It is not coming to the next line of execution. Then it has clicked on logout and came out. Okay, click and wait. Have you understood the difference between click? It will click and next second it comes to the next line of execution. If you use click and wait, it will wait for the amount of time what the default timeout value is mentioned in the Selenium IDE. Default timeout value, by default it will be given as 30 seconds. You can change the time, because if your internet is very slow, or else if your application is slow, if you want to wait for 60 seconds, then you want to change the default timeout value. Okay, just take down as difference between click and wait. That we will see again, the same topic we will cover in Selenium WebDriver again. But we will see in a different way there. Now, see, I said that it takes 30 seconds, right? Where is that 30 seconds mentioned? In Selenium IDE, go to options here, and here you have 30,000 milliseconds. Default timeout value is given 30 seconds. Change this time and click on OK. So that it will wait for a maximum amount of time what you have mentioned here. But if the page loads in 5 seconds, it will automatically synchronize. Okay, we will see in detail about synchronization, concept of synchronization later. Once we start with Selenium WebDriver. Okay, if you know basic how to record a test case, how to save a test case, and how to run the test case in Selenium IDE, that is more than sufficient. okay, some small adjustments like this, click and wait. Okay, once we see the Selenium web driver, right, we will see in detail about synchronization, all those things. We have a separate concept called concept of synchronization. One day we completely will see on this concept of synchronization, what is implicitly wait, explicitly wait, default timeout value, all those things. Okay, this is the overall content what we are going to see. First, we will be seeing of basics of testing and automation. I will give you time to take down this. Listen, today we have saw about Selenium ID. These two are 1 hour, 1 hour topics. This it will take tomorrow's topic, basics of HTML we will learn. Okay, next we will learn about element locators. Then we will see Java topics. Just for 3 days like that, we will see Java topics. It will not end up there. By Java topics will not end up there. Again, in between Selenium WebDriver, we will see a lot of Java topics again. Because all of a sudden, we will learn, if you learn Java, and if you go to Selenium WebDriver directly, what happens in the interview, they will ask the relation between a particular topic in Java and how it is related to Selenium WebDriver. You cannot make a correlation there. That's why what we do, we'll learn some basics of Java. Directly we jump to Selenium WebDriver. We'll learn Java topics and Selenium WebDriver topics parallelly, so that we'll understand 100% better enough. Okay, then we'll start with Selenium WebDriver. All these topics, it will be very new for you. At the last, we'll learn about real-time project, skeleton code implement, and Maven, Jenkins, Cucumber, everything you'll learn here. This is the content at the first page of your notebook. Take down this content. After finishing each and every topic, just mark it as done. If I miss any one or two topics, just let me know at the end of the classes. I mean, after finishing all our classes, so that you will have a roadmap clearly. How much percentage we have covered, at least we will come to know about that here. And few topics, it will take 2 days or 3 days like this. And few topics like drag and drop, I will complete in 15 minutes. This topic will take only 15 minutes. On an average, this is divided based on 1.5 hour of our classes. Daily we'll have 1.5 hour, right? On an average, it is 1.5 hour, so that it will take 38 classes it will take to complete. Okay, and coming to the leave plans, I'll be taking leave on 13th and 14th. I will be taking leave. I mean, next Monday, Tuesday, I will be taking leave. Wednesday, by default, it is leave anyhow. August 15th, Independence Day. Here in India, we celebrate Independence Day. That's why we take leave. And 13, 14, 15. Tomorrow, we will have class. Next class will be on 16th only. Until that, we have continuous leave because I am going out of Bangalore on 13th and 14th. I won't be available here. Okay, 16th onwards we will have the next class, and we will not be having any leaves. Only one leave I will take. Any one leave after that, I don't know the exact date when I will be taking the leave. That is the only leave plans what I have. There is no other leaves what I will be taking, and it will take this many days to complete the class. Until we come, we take up to this classes concept of synchronization. You don't decide anything. Whether we can learn or not, something, whether it is easy or not. Going further, once we start from here, you will come to know the exact value of what you are learning here. Once we start with checkpoints in Selenium, once we start with this, you will be understanding what exactly you are learning here. Until that, you will be something, blindly you will be learning few things. Learn those things, not a problem, so that you will understand better enough from going from these topics. This is all about our class. Take down this. Once you are done with this, we can leave for the day. From tomorrow onwards, you will have 1.5 hour of class for sure. Yeah. Which one? Here. How to change the default timeout value? Options. Go to options, you will get this window. Take down in your notebook, don't take snaps. Take down in your notebook, don't be too lazy. From tomorrow onwards, you will have lot and lot to take down in your notes also. Last 15 minutes of class. Here, change the default timeout value. Default timeout value of recorded, that you have to take down. That's it. just install once Selenium IDE, practice once and leave it. No need to worry about that if you are not getting output also, just leave it. Because that got outdated. This is the contents, main content. Yeah, tell me, Sarit. Firefox plugin. Yes, that is the same thing again. What you are installing like this, it will install into the plugin. If you whatever the steps, whatever I have said, right? See, just a minute, guys. You can one more thing. He is asking, can I install the Selenium IDE like this? Go to tools, go to add-ons. Okay, here you can search for Selenium IDE. Search for this, you will get Selenium IDE here. You will get install button directly here itself. Install button. If you click on install, right, it will install Selenium IDE. You can install like this also. But when you have a version compatibility issues, right, sometimes it will be grayed out. You cannot find out why it is grayed out. That's why I said you that way of installing. Both the ways it is same. Have you got it, Sarit? Okay, fine. Take down. Video, you will get it on another by 2 p.m. you will get it. Yesterday's and today's as well. Sarit, please mute your mic. This, just a minute, and take down this.